How you doing, cat gang? Harrison here to let you know that I still have two felines. I'm really excited to bring you guys this solo fallen strat. I consider it my first official solo fallen strat of the winter update because it's not a remake of an older strat like the one I did yesterday, and it's not a tryhard strat to solo a dual lane map like the Candy Valley one is. This strat is also my official Toxic Gunner solo fallen strat because it uses Toxic Gunner, Ace Pilot for the Hiddens of course, Farm, Commander, and Ranger. This is kind of a weird game because I'm not using a DJ, which is pretty rare for a solo fallen strat, but I actually didn't need it because of how much the Toxic Gunner slows the enemies down and because of the way this map is laid out. The zigzagging path keeps the zombies close enough to the Rangers to where they're almost always within their range, and any enemies that might move outside of the Rangers' range are slowed down by the Toxic Gunners. Now, the first major drawback of this strat that I want to go ahead and get out in the open right now is the fact that as of the making of this video, the Toxic Gunner is bugged. Its slowing effect is permanent, but it isn't supposed to be. This means that whenever the day comes that the TDS devs fix this issue, the strat might no longer work. The one thing that could save it is if they change the slowing effect so that it lasts just long enough for you to kind of stagger the Toxic Gunners along the path in such a way that allows them to always be slowing the enemies down. Because there's only a few enemies that really need to be slowed, like the glitches, the errors, the tank, and the Fallen King himself. So even once they fix that tower, this might still work. You're actually gonna see that even with the Toxic Gunner working the way it does now, I still have to stagger them. This is to be sure to catch anything fast that the summoner bosses spawn. One super annoying thing about playing on this map is that from the camera angle that I used, the stupid building right in front of the Rangers kept blocking me from seeing what was happening on the other side. So I wasn't able to easily see if the zombies were dying or if I was about to get overrun. Just go ahead and watch this video all the way to the end to see what I mean. Now, even though the Ace Pilots are going to give the Toxic Gunners hidden detection, I didn't put any of them close enough to the Rangers to give them hidden detection. I didn't really feel like I had to worry about this because a group of Ace Pilots can easily shred the shadow bosses. You're also going to see that I put an Ace at the end just to catch any enemies that happen to get through the main group. A really nice advantage you're going to have with the Ace Pilots here comes from the way this map is set up. At the two main sections where I place them, they're going to be moving in the opposite direction of the zombies, which allows the Ace to do maximum damage, especially the big group I place in the middle. Yeah, I relied way more on the Ace Pilot in this game than I ever have before. Honestly, this was kind of a weird game. I didn't really focus on spamming call to arms. I just kind of did it when I wanted. I think this was because the Toxic Gunner slowed everything down so much that it kind of made it too easy. Now, if I remember correctly, I did lose this challenge the first time I tried it, but I think that was because I didn't have the Ace in the back. So be sure you put that down. And because the Ace Pilot is going to be your only hidden detection, you're going to want to be sure to have one upgraded to level 4 by the time wave 13 starts. And just like the minigunner on the Crossroads map game, you're going to be focusing on upgrading your farms as soon as possible so that you can pay for those expensive max level Rangers. Since you're not using the DJ to decrease the cost of anything, you're going to have to pay full price for those suckers. As always, the strategy document will be down in the description, and if you have any questions about it, be sure to leave them for me down in the comments. Now go ahead and sit back, relax, grab a healthy cat, and let's get toxic. Holy smokes! I had totally forgotten about this gameplay until I just edited the video. Did you guys notice that I didn't even place a commander down until wave 31? And I only had 5 rangers down when wave 35 started. What kind of strat is this? Oh yeah, it's the toxic gunner. It's just too OP right now. And not having to use the DJ was actually kind of fun. It's nice to have a different kind of solo fallen strategy to use, you know what I mean? Now if you enjoyed this video, be sure to smash that like button with your forehead, hit the subscribe button with your big toe, and turn on notifications however you can so you don't miss any of my amazing upcoming content. And I will see you guys next time. Take care, be safe, and never forget what I always say. Peace!